Howdy, folks. From Lake Superior, Big Top, Chautauqua, at the top of Wisconsin, welcome to another episode of Tent Show Radio.
I can't believe another year's gone around. Is that a big top I see there high above the ground? Ballyhoo. Oh, ballyhoo.
Support for Tent Show Radio is provided by Travel Wisconsin. There's a million ways to have fun in Wisconsin and no reason not to. Visit TravelWisconsin.com and plan your trip today. And now, here's your host of Tent Show Radio, best-selling author, humorist, singer-songwriter, and intermittent pig farmer, Michael Perry.
Howdy, folks, and welcome to Tent Show Radio from Big Top Chautauqua. Tonight, we feature a performance by our very own Blue Canvas Orchestra, known to friends of the tent as BCO. And that brings me to some tough news. One of the founding members of the BCO, T. Bruce Bowers, has left this world for another. Our hearts are with his family, Yasmin and Hope. And during this broadcast, there will be a whole bunch of us conjuring a vision of T. Bruce up there, drawing magic from his violin. And towards the end of the broadcast, we'll bring the spirit of Bruce via song to the very front of the Big Top stage. Folks, the music you're about to hear emanates from a special space in a special place. It's the Big Top Chautauqua, an actual giant canvas tent pitched atop a green hill overlooking beautiful Bayfield, Wisconsin, and dotting Lake Superior in the far blue distance, those all-natural jewels called the Apostle Islands. Life is slow up here, so you want to get here as fast as you can. Imagine you're here right now, in a canvas tent pitched in the theater of your mind. And if you enjoy what you hear over the course of the next hour and want to see it and experience it firsthand, check the schedule and get your tickets at www.bigtop.org. It sounds beautiful up here because it is beautiful up here. You ought to come on up. The Blue Canvas Orchestra has been punching in, tuning up, stepping out, and getting down as long as this tent has had pegs. They provide the musical bed other performers build on. They deliver the notated sounds behind the original Big Top productions, and then sometimes, like tonight, we just turn them loose to do whatever they want, which means you're going to get some folk, some blues, some classical, and some whatever you got. Each member is a virtuoso in his, her, or their own right, but together they are. Please welcome them now, the Lake Superior Big Top Chautauqua Blue Canvas Orchestra.
Don't get up tight and heat up some coffee ground. don't elbow me.
Let the four winds blow, ho, 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 all around this tent floor. I might be far off, but I think we did this once before. There's more frost on the window glass with each new tender kiss. Sure is.
That's Tom Mitchell.
Well, here's a tune by Blind Willie Johnson, my favorite kind of tune. It has one chord in it. It's really easy to teach the band. It only uses two notes of the chord, so it's quite simple, and two of them are the open strings. So I'm pretty much set. It's called Soul of a Man. It's a title track to a record I did a few years ago. If you want a copy of it, you can get it online, or you can flag down my avocado green VW camper bus on the main street of Washburn. We'll make a deal. Street deal.
To ask you, answer if you can. Is there anybody here who can tell me what is the soul of a man? Well, I want somebody to tell me. Answer if you can. I want somebody to tell me. Oh, brother, what is the soul? This country, I travel to the furthest land. I ain't found no one to tell me yet what is the soul of a man. Well, I want somebody to tell me. Answer if you can. I want somebody to tell me. Brother, what is the soul of a man? Just in time to hear the doctor and the lawyer say a man ain't nothing but your mind. Well, I want somebody to tell me.
Want somebody to tell me.
Answer if you can.
Answer if you can.
I want somebody to tell me.
Tell me what is the soul of a man.
Tell me, Bruce.
nothing but a burning light. Yeah, 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 I want somebody to tell me.
Want somebody to tell me.
Answer if you can.
Tell me if you can.
I want somebody to tell me.
Want somebody to tell me.
What is the soul of a man? Well, I want somebody to tell me. Answer if you can.
I actually had somebody come up to me at the Minnesota State Fair last year when I was playing with my band, and at the intermission, he told me the answer to that, and I promptly forgot it, sadly. So.
Hey, we're going to do a tune that I wrote, and this is a tune called I Breathe In, and it was one of the only times that a tune came to me in the night. I woke up and wrote down most of this, which is hilarious for me because usually I'm working on something for a year and rewriting it and it's scratched out and that sucks and you know, I mean, but this one, I don't know, it's came pretty quickly, so I'm waiting for that miracle to happen again. I doubt that it will, but please enjoy. Yeah, it's called I Breathe In. And the tempo of this tune, I know you were about to ask about the tempo. I could see it. It's written all over your faces. But the tempo is, I was trying to slow my breath down to just not be a maniac. And so this is when I'm hyperventilating for some reason, I think of this tune. So here you go. That's way too much information. Now that I've spoiled the tune for you, we'll go ahead. Given one more chance to love again, when so many around me have found their end. So I search for my courage and I think of them.
Ed Willett. Yeah, Ed.
You are listening to Tent Show Radio.
Welcome to intermission, folks. This week, as I reflected on the life and music of T. Bruce Bowers, I thought of the night last summer when a man showed me a photo of his parents taken around the time they met. The man's father was a Midwestern GI stationed overseas, his mother a Japanese seamstress. Faced with a language barrier and no other means of arranging a date, the young soldier would purposely cut the buttons from his uniform so he had an excuse to visit the seamstress. Decades evaporate. The soldier and the seamstress are gone. The black and white photos taken when they met paired with a snapshot of the two of them, gray-haired and elderly, framed and smiling from the wall of a small rural Wisconsin cabin, decorated to commemorate their lives and love, as well as a grandson who died young. Outside the cabin, a large group of friends and family sat around a bonfire in a small outdoor bar as part of an annual gathering honoring those gone on. The firelit group was celebrating, swapping stories and, in quieter, more private moments, running a thumb along the edge of harder memories to see if they had gone dull. They rarely do. I came to the gathering by chance in slow degrees, beginning back a decade or so when the man who owns the cabin and I were waiting in line at the local gas station during deer season. This was back when you had to haul your deer to town to register it, so the line was moving slowly and we struck up a conversation. Time passed, and at some point the man started a lawn mowing service. One day our old mower disappeared in a blurt of blue smoke, and the man bailed us out with his equipment. This led to us shooting the breeze in the yard. That led to him lending me his torpedo heater to save my shed roof from the snow last winter, and that led to an invitation to the bonfire. I don't want to overstep. The man with the cabin and I are on friendly and relaxed terms, but I'm not his confidant. I can't really overshare, as I'm not privy to that level. Rather, I carry the vision of those black and white photos beside the full-color snapshot taken a lifetime later, and how it causes me to view my own life in terms of decades rather than this afternoon's chore list. How we stood in that little room looking at the photos of the three departed, even as the noise from the bonfire circle echoed across the yard, present evidence that the three lives represented remained cause for celebration off some county road among the dark Wisconsin pines. You wonder in these moments what sort of bonfire you might precipitate, if any. Not the usual ephemeral monuments, the faded commemorations, the brass plaques for the young to pass by and briefly wonder who that was, and not even the full funeral home, but rather the stories passed around the flickering circle, the passing smile on the face of the person back in the shadows, the sparks and smoke rising as we toss another stick on the fire to keep it burning. And tonight, of course, woven in and around and through the songs from the stage, the music of T. Bruce Bowers. Let's go back now to the BCO.
Thank you.
That was called The Maiden's Prayer.
Now you're going to see some real culture under canvas. Ed, maybe you can tell us a little bit about this piece.
Well, we had a request for some Rossini, and no, we didn't. We didn't, actually. I requested that we play some Rossini. Vince and I play classical music together, and we're going to play a short piece by Rossini. And this was written for, was commissioned by a wealthy man who Vince will remember and I won't, so let's just say he's a wealthy man. But there was a famous bassist by the name of Dragonetti, and there was this cellist who was an amateur cellist but wanted a piece written, so they paid Rossini to write this piece. Is that correct, Vince?
That's correct.
Vince writes the program notes for the Duluth Symphony, so it makes me very nervous to say anything factual in front of him. Yeah, because I get charged later. And we're going to bring Severin Behnen up to turn my pages because I just couldn't figure it out. This is a pressure gig, Sev. Okay. Yeah. Can you reach all that there? Is that? Yeah. And I kind of know it, so yeah, that's going to work. Okay. You're doing a fine job so far, except I'm going to skewer you with my bow. It's one of the hazards of turning pages is not as safe as people would assume.
Hazardous duty.
Yeah. Yeah, that's good. That's good. All right. Here we go. After all that, we better be good.
That's right.
Thank you.
Thank you. Rossini, 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 Rossini. Yeah, I knew it. Gee, honey, where can we go and hear a bass and cello duet tonight by Rossini? Wait.
That's about the only
The Big Top, they'll probably have something like that.
Ladies will be waiting for a man who can dance. I'll be by to pick you up. We'll take the motor car. We ought to leave soon, be in town a little early. Have dinner at the hotel before the dance. Take a bath, get a shave and a shoe shine.
Blue Canvas Orchestra, folks. Throughout the show, I've alluded to T. Bruce Bowers and his presence in the mix. Now we're going to bring his memory forward. T. Bruce was a founding member of the BCO. His music filled this tent and ears and hearts all around the world in over 20 film and television scores and touched souls beyond all that in ways we'll never know. We send our hearts to his partner Hope and daughter Yasmin, and take a moment now to close our eyes and listen to the T. Bruce Bowers we were all privileged to know, seeing him in our memory keeping barefooted time, leaning into that electric violin, and summoning magic from the book. Thank you. hands of T. Bruce Bowers, ladies and gentlemen. And now to close the show, with a final salute to the music man, who was also a family man, we respectfully lower the tent lights and put ourselves back in a distant evening as Bruce's daughter Yasmin steps to the microphone to sing one of her songs. And right there beside her, playing as only a dad can, is T. Bruce.
When the darkness falls and the cold blows in, and I'm feeling poor, and I don't know where to turn, that restless voice again. I hear it say, I know there's something bigger out there. It's on days like these when my heart breaks free. Just you and me, staring at the sun, and I wonder where the wind is blowing now, 'cause it feels like something bigger is coming in. It's some days like these when my heart breaks.
So long, T. Bruce. We still hear you.
Support for Tent Show Radio is provided by Travel Wisconsin. There's a million ways to have fun in Wisconsin and no reason not to. Visit travelwisconsin.com and plan your trip today. And we're brought to you by the Ashland Chamber of Commerce. Ashland, Wisconsin, where you find yourself next to the water. Year-round recreation in the heart of Shawamigan Bay. More information at visitashland.com. And we're brought to you by the Bayfield Chamber of Commerce. Beautiful Bayfield and the Apostle Islands. You can tour sea caves and shop our galleries and stores on the shores of Lake Superior. Information and lodging at bayfield.org. And we're brought to you by the Bayfield Inn, located on the shoreline of Lake Superior in downtown Bayfield. Stay, dine, and relax with the Bayfield Inn year-round. With 21 hotel rooms, over 25 vacation rentals, a lounge, on-site restaurant, and rooftop bar. There's something for you at the Bayfield Inn, any traveler, any season, any meal. Information at thebayfieldinn.com or facebook.com/Bayfield Inn.
Well, folks, that's our show for tonight. Whether you beam it or stream it, we thank you for listening. We're as grateful as a guy who's had a chance to hear some everlasting music from an everlasting soul. We'd love it if you come on up Bayfield Way or down or over through for a live show. Details always available at bigtop.com. You can visit me anytime at sneezingcow.com. Until next we share the air, remember, where I come from, and here at Tent Show Radio, nobody ever says goodbye. They just say, well, I suppose.